When you're spraying weeds in a big lawn, particularly this large turf area at the State Botanical Garden in Athens, you quickly figure out that a little pump-up sprayer is not going to make it. It takes a long time to get herbicide on all these weeds. We've got about an acre here. By the way, you may see some students behind me. They're in their entomology class collecting butterflies here at the State Botanical Garden too. Well, if you figure that the pump-up sprayer is not exactly the tool you want to use to distribute herbicide, there is an alternative. It's called a hose-end sprayer, and I like it a lot for covering a large area, whether with herbicides or pesticides, like insecticides that you might want to apply in your backyard. They've been around for a long time, really. You can see this one that Ortho used to make a long time ago, had a glass jar. Of course, that would break pretty easily, and I'm sure they made a pretty penny in replacing those glass jars. But the way they work is actually pretty simple. It hasn't changed in a long time. It has a tube inside. The tube, of course, fits down in the bottom of the container of pesticide. You connect the hose to this end, and in the Venturi principle, the scientific principle called the Venturi principle, as the stream of water goes across the top of this little black tube, it sucks up pesticide, which is down at the bottom of the tube. It mixes it at a certain rate, and then the water rushes out the end of the gun right here. And this one is made for spraying up in trees and shrubs, so it can spray for a long distance. But these hose-end sprayers, as I say, are pretty clever gizmo. But there have been some improvements over the years. Here's one that I have found recently that I like a lot. Still sort of the same principle. You have the strainer on the end of a long tube, of course. Put it down inside the plastic container now so it doesn't break quite as easily. And it has a dial on the side. Let me see if you can see this. See, the dial on the side has numbers on it. And so you can actually tell the sprayer how much of the pesticide you want to add to the flow of water that's going through the gun on top. And today, in our particular case, I'm going to use a pesticide that says use 1 fluid ounce or 2 tablespoons per gallon of water. So I can turn the dial. As you see, I've already got it on a 1 ounce right there, but it has many different settings on it depending on the particular pesticide that you're using. I'll move it back to the 1 ounce right there. And so you take the herbicide, in our case, and pour it undiluted into the container. Now, of course, whenever you're using any kind of pesticide, it's important to protect your eyes, protect your skin, like I am with the gloves right here. But you don't have to measure in this case. So we'll just pour this herbicide down into the container till we have enough to treat this large area. And then, because the dial allows it to meter the amount of herbicide that goes into the water stream, all we then have to do is to put it on top, fasten it in place, and then connect the water hose to the end. As you can also see, it has a nice trigger right here, which allows you to control the flow of water through it when you're walking back and forth through your lawn. Now, this is the easy way to do it, but there are a couple of other gizmos that, in fact, this one's still made by Ortho and looks very similar to the one I showed you earlier, although they have given us the plastic container again. But in this particular case, the way that it is used does not have a dial on top, as you can see, nothing up here other than a valve to turn the flow of water on and off. In this particular case, you have to read the side of your pesticide container. In this case, again, 1 tablespoon for 2 ounces. Obviously, I would not be spraying a herbicide, tree or a shrub, but let's assume that we're going to spray an insecticide there. And you would measure, let's say we're going to use a gallon of pesticide. We measure the 1 tablespoon in there, and then we add water to the container to bring it up to the mark that's right on the side of the container. Now, the pesticide there is slightly diluted with the water, and when they have been diluted, screw the top back on, and again, connect it to the water hose, and then use that to spray real high up into shrubs or trees. But note that there's a difference between the two. The one that has the dial, you can actually set the application rate with the dial. The one that does not have a dial, you have to estimate, basically, how much herbicide or how much pesticide you're going to use, dilute it with water up to the line on the side of the container, and then connect the hose to it, and use that to spray it onto the lawn or up into the tree or wherever you're going to use it. Well, now let's demonstrate. I have a hose that's fully charged right here. I'll connect it to the sprayer. Turn the water on. Let's go over here. Now, you usually want to walk backwards across your lawn. You don't want to be walking through the pesticide. And you want to note how wide the swath is that you're applying. So basically, let's put my hand behind me to control the hose. And then we'll cut it off. You walk forward, a little bit over to the left there. Back again, and so on and so forth. As you can see, this is a quick and easy way to apply herbicides, insecticides, fungicides, whatever it is that you want to apply to your lawn. Now, after you've applied it, the material that's left in the sprayer can simply be poured back into the container that it originally came from. We pour this back in here, but then you'll need to wash this out, rinse it out real good, use that rinsate to put on other weeds around the corners of your landscape so you're still using it in a manner that's indicated on the label of the product. Well, I think you can see that there's a lot of potential in using these hose end sprayers. They can be used anywhere you have a water source that has good high pressure to it, and they really do save a lot of time, particularly compared to these little old pump-up hand sprayers.